Hey everyone, maybe you heard that we just released a new update 4.4.1 for our Commander and the S3XY application. But if you haven't checked it yet, make sure to go down inside the description because I'm going to leave the video of our presentation of this new update. But today I want to go a little bit deeper into all the features that we added and what we have improved also with the new version that we just released. The first thing I want to say is that this update was mainly for the Commander and the S3XY buttons. I see a lot of people in the comments say my knob didn't receive almost anything. Guys, it's two different products. We are developing both of them at the same time. You just need to give us a little bit extra few days and we're going to release a big update also for the knob as well. But today we're mainly going to talk about the Commander and the buttons and what's been added new to them. So the first thing I want to talk about is the macros. As you've seen in our presentation, this is a big change for us. We already gave the option to control up to three features at a single click of a S3XY button. So let me show you how to set it up. Basically, you need to go inside the S3XY app, and I have this button right here paired with my application. And now I need to choose what to add as a single pressable button. So basically, I go just a standard to plus, and let's say I want to create a macro where I open my glove box and I turn on the dome lights at the same time. So what I'm going to choose right now is go to open, go into glove box and press save. And immediately after I do this, there's a second button that comes right underneath, says add another action. So when I press on this, I can choose my second option, which is going to be all the way down in others, called interior lights, or how we call it, dome lights. And when I press it save, I can see that now I have a single press macro created between these two functions right here. So let's see how it's going to work. As you can see, the glove box is closed and the dome lights are off. So let me press the button right now. Once the dome lights are on and the glove box is open. So this is pretty cool. And I believe a lot of you are going to get super creative with it. Again, I just added only two features, but you can add up to three and just go crazy with it. You know, we actually create a special group in Discord that you can join and tell us what your macro ideas are. So maybe you can share it with the community so they can start using it also, because, you know, sometimes somebody needs a little bit motivation. The second thing I want to talk about today is the new dashboard. As you've seen a few months ago, we added this minimal Tesla looking like dashboard, but now we also expanded it and went into creating a feature where you can watch it in a landscape mode as well. And one extra cool thing I want to tell you about the dashboard is that you can actually pre-select it to be active on auto rotation. So basically I need to go inside the settings up here, choose auto rotate dashboard, go back. And now every time I rotate my phone, the dashboard is going to respond to my rotation. What else is inside the dash? So as you can see right now, this is the basic, the standard, the most minimal style of dashboard there is, but you can choose up to another four of presets that we added. And the presets are in the settings of the dashboard. You can go right here on this button. When you enter it, these are our five presets that we have. We actually have a sixth one, which we call custom, but that's going to be available later on. But let's say I want to choose a dashboard that has more buttons to add it to it. So when I press it, I have these six features currently added to these six buttons. On the left side, I'm going to be able to watch the performance of my right of the front motor and my rear motor. And obviously on the center, it's the speedometer, which is the basic version as we saw. But what's happening if I want to change these buttons? It's very simple. We added an extra feature to the new update where you can press and hold on an action, and you can choose or you want to change it, or you want to add a stat to it, or you want to delete it. So let's say right now it's a rear left door opener, and if I want to change it to, let's say I want to open my frunk, I just save the action and bam, now this button opens my frunk. I can again customize all these buttons, and I know in the main video I said that this is going to be available with the next update, but we were a little bit quicker than we thought, so we were able to release it a bit sooner. Another cool option that we added to the new dashboard is that you can finally also change its appearance. So if you go again to the settings screen, and if you swipe down, you have three options. You can make it auto, which is basically going to correspond with the screen of your Tesla. So let's check it out. If I press on auto, you see it became bright. So now if I close it, this screen is bright and this screen is also bright, which I believe it's very useful. And we've actually done a poll about this on Reddit about, I would say, 6 months ago. How do you guys prefer to have a dashboard set up, as an auto, as a light, or as a dark skin? And a lot of you voted for auto, I believe over 1,000 people. So that's why we have all these three options now for you. And obviously you can go into dark mode, which I personally prefer to have, but it's all up to you. What else you have in the dashboard? You obviously have the frank mode, which we had for such a long time. You have a dash on start, which means that every time this is selected and you close the app, every time you open it, it's going to immediately go into the dashboard rather than going to the home screen. And also we have show brake light on or off, which means, do you want to see the brake light appears at the bottom when you actually press the brake light inside the Tesla, or this one, or you don't want to have it? Some people, you know, just want to have a minimal look and you can remove it and you're not going to be able to see it. So this is pretty much about the dashboard. We're going to be expanding on it heavily. One thing we're going to be adding is right on this side, you're going to be able to see the live features that you activate through the sexy buttons or the knob, which is pretty cool. So this way, all of you who have the dashboard right here at the front, you're going to be able to see real time when some of your features are activated or not on this side. But that's going to be probably available with the next update that we're going to release in about a couple of months. That's enough about the dashboard. Let's move forward. Another feature we added is the seat adjustment, which you guys went crazy. So let me show you actually where to find it. When you go inside the actions of the buttons, you have to scroll down and there's a brand new section called seat adjustment. You press on plus and there's so many options to choose from. But let's say right now, just for the demonstration, I want to control my backrest and I want to move it forward. So the left one is always going to be the one on the left of your car, obviously. So you save it. You go back, and now every time when I press on this button right here, the backrest is going to start moving, and when I press again, it's going to stop. And you can obviously assign this to the buttons, to the app, and eventually you're going to be able to assign it to the knob as well. So all of you, the sexy knob users, don't get mad at us. This feature is coming to you very, very soon. But I want to point out one very important thing is that sometimes when you start using this action, the Tesla screen, when it detects that there's nobody on the seat, it might give you a little warning saying something along the lines that the seat is moving without needed to be moved or something like this. So no need to panic. It's just a warning because Tesla doesn't realize that you're actually moving the seat because you're not pressing the button on it. We're tricking the system, obviously, as you know. So just use it cautiously. Use it as it makes sense. Don't play around with it. You know, don't give it maybe to your kids just to press it back and forward for no reason. Just use it intentionally. That's our only opinion. And as I mentioned in the main video, that we have a super cool feature that we're going to experiment with this option for the seat controls, which we're super excited to show it to you when it's available. But for that, make sure to subscribe to our channel, because once we are ready, we're going to point it out. And by the way, one cool thing to mention about the seat adjustment feature is that it's available for all the Tesla models, something that a lot of other products you might have seen from Far East cannot produce. Also, they require long additional wiring that you need to connect, like a second commander connected to your seat, and you can only move the passenger seat but not the driver's seat. With our feature and with our commander, you can do everything you can think of. You don't need any additional wiring. You can just control both seats together, separately, you name it. Again, check everything we do on our channel. Another thing we showed on our presentation video is that we already gave you the option to control your motors when it comes to a all-wheel drive cars. A lot of you are confused why we haven't released this, but you have no idea how many people on Discord are asking us, can we do this for them or not? So basically, let me show you where you can find it. When you press again on the actions, you can swipe down, you can go into traction control, and in there, obviously you can see the drift mode features, but this is not a drift mode. option, but this is only a disable front or disable a rear motor. So obviously, if I choose the front one, my car is going to turn into a rear wheel drive vehicle. You can accept. When I press on the button here, let's see what's going to happen on the Tesla main screen. So first of all, you always need to be in park. You cannot do this while you're driving. I know a lot of you are getting creative and you want to change it on the fly. No. Let's start slow and let's do it from the park position first. So let's say right now I'm in park, and when I press on disable front motor, bam, there is a warning that Tesla gives you that your one of your motors is disabled. And actually on the top, you can see it's a front one. So what's going to happen now? Only the rear one is going to perform any discharge, and only the rear one is going to get a regen. But if you want to activate your front motor, you don't need to get out of the car or restart the vehicle. You can just press the button again. So I press on it when I'm in park, and bam, the warning is gone. My car is back to all-wheel drive as was intended before. And this is a feature that it's brand new. We haven't experimented too much with it. So please go down in the comments if you used it and share your experience with us, with the rest of the community. You know, a lot of people are interested about it, so they want to hear from you. Now I want to talk a little bit more about small improvements and bug changes that we actually fixed with this update. One is going to be amazing for this weather. Actually, right now, as you can see, it's raining, and a lot of you know that you don't like the performance of the wipers of your Tesla. So years ago, you requested a feature where you can disable your wipers during your autopilot drives, and we've done that for you. But sometimes the Tesla was re-engaging them forcefully because, again, it's, you know, Tesla wants to do things that doesn't make sense sometimes. But we found a way to actually improve this feature, and let me show you where to find it. So right now, when you go into the commander section, as you know, we have a thing called smart actions. These are our automations that we created for your vehicle. And if you go into the auto off section, before there was a force manual high beams off. So basically your high beams were always stay off even when you're on autopilot, and the same thing for the wipers. But now we added a third feature that's called keep wipers off. So when you enable it, what basically this is going to do is every time your wipers are trying to get activated and then shift from off to auto, the commander is going to immediately shift them back to off, and they're going to stay there, and you cannot do anything to move it back to auto. You can, even if you press manually on the auto button, it's still going to shift back to off. But what you can do is change the levels of performance of the wipers, or you're going to be able to place them, put them into off, but never to auto. So this is for those people that really, really hate the auto wipers and they never want to use it. I believe this feature is going to be really, really useful for you. So check it out. And I hope this time you're happier. Another big improvement we added to this update is the presenting door smart action, which is one of my personally favorite ones. So let me show you where you can find it. Again, you need to go into the commander tab, then scroll a little bit and find the presenting doors. What this basically does, it pops open your door, your driver's door, when you're approaching your vehicle. So when you activate this feature, you have a few options to select. You can disable one of the honks when the car is getting unlocked. You can, if your car is parked very close to the place you live, you can disable this feature so your door never, you know, unlocks when you're at home sitting and just watching TV. Because again, when the commander detects the Bluetooth of your phone, they make a connection and they think that you're approaching the vehicle, so you want to get inside the vehicle, so that's why the door opens. So basically when you're at home, I suggest you to enable this setting so it never the door opens for you. And there's other settings you can play around with and check it out, but the best thing is that now we finally added the option to control the newer versions of the cars. Before this update, a lot of the owners of Teslas built before the 2023 were able to use this feature. Now a lot of the new owners are going to be enjoy it too, especially if you're a Model 3 Highland owner. You're probably going to enjoy this feature as well, so give it a try. It's a very useful feature that a lot of you are going to find a great use for. So check it out and let us know if it's working on your model or not. Another improvement that we added to this update is giving you the option to rename your buttons inside the application. So let me show you how to do this. So let's say right now this button here is on my steering wheel, and these are the functions that are paired to it. But the name of it is button number one, which is nothing that gives me, you know, reminder of where this button is placed. So basically what I can do now is I can press on the button, press on the name, and I can say, let's name it a wheel button, like on the steering wheel button. When I save it, it successfully saves. Now when I go back, I know that my steering wheel button, when I go inside of it, I can change any of the functions I want this button to perform, which is one of the top requests that we got from you long time ago. Sorry it took us a little bit longer to perform it, but we just had another task that we first had to finish. And the last thing I want to talk about today is the new Tesla Cloud features that we just added to the Sexy app. If you do not know what these are, make sure to follow Dimitri's video right here. He's going to give you a full walkthrough how to set it up with your application and what it does for you. But right now I'm going to show you a few of the features that we were able to add to our app and how you can control it with the buttons and with the knob. So come check it out. So right now, when you go to add a new action to your buttons or your app, you're going to see two sections of features that you can choose from. One is by Commander and another is by the Cloud. And the Cloud features are relatively limited, but there are some cool options. And let's say I want to control the HVAC of this vehicle. So I'm going to control climate control options, choose the on off feature, save it. And now on my dashboard, I'm going to have the on off option. So right now you can see on the Tesla main screen that the HVAC is on. And when I press on the button, it's going to go off. And when I press it again, it's going to go on, which is pretty cool. And there's about 15 new features added through this Tesla API that you can play around with, see how it works. And please know that, yes, right now you can do it via the Sexy buttons or you can use them via the Sexy app. However, we are also going to be adding it to the Sexy knob as well. So don't worry, we haven't forgot about you. They're going to be available with one of the next updates. Actually, we already added two of the features to the knob, and let me show you how it works. Before this update, the knob's temperature was not corresponding with the main display of your Tesla, but now it does. So right now, when I go in to the temperature setting and I increase it to 22, it jumps up to 22 on the main display as well, and you can play with it as you wish. And we also added seat heater control, which is also corresponding here. So let's say if I want to increase the temperature of my driver's seat, it also shows it on the display, something that it wasn't showing before. Yes, there's a lot of features that are still missing, and we're going to be adding them slowly when Tesla allows us to do that. But it's a big improvement. A lot of you are going to be happy to see that finally you have extra controls and comfort with the knob and with the buttons. And since I mentioned that this is a brand new thing that Tesla released, it's not quite optimized yet, so we are working on making it more user-friendly. But for now, just to make sure that all these features are working for you and they're synchronized, you need to have your Sexy app open or foreground. Maybe on some phones like the iPhone, it's going to be working on background as well. But that's another reason why you should be using the Sexy tiles or the dashboard at all times. Now you have another reason why to do that. I'm pretty sure we're going to find a smarter way how to control it, or Tesla is going to optimize it before we do. So just make sure to follow all the updates and we're going to get you notified when it's available. But that's pretty much it for this update. I hope you guys learned a lot. I'm going to be making a lot of videos like this with every new update because you guys asked for it a lot in our last video. So get used to seeing my face. See you soon.